I'm Neha Gupta, and today I'll be presenting my paper on towards Modi-script digital preservation. So the title of the paper is towards Modi-script preservation tools for digitization, wherein we will be proposing some of the tools for digitizing the heritage script. Basically, the area which comes under this paper is language and heritage preservation of the scripts. We all four authors belongs to Center for Development of Advanced Computing, which is a scientific society under Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, Government of India. So I'll be starting with the Modi script and historical overview. So as far as Modi, the origin of the Modi is concerned, and this is always a debatable issue. According to some of the historian, Modi can be dated back to the Maurya dynasty. Hence, the name is Modi, because Maurya and Modi both are very, that dynasty, the Modi name come from that dynasty. And Hemadri Pant is credited with the invention of the Modi script, and date assigned to its birth is around year 1260. So why the Modi was invented? Actually, before Modi, we have Devanagari script, wherein mostly in India, we have more than 10 scheduled Indian languages comes from the Devanagari. So why we needed at that time Modi? So in the Devanagari script, what happened, whenever you were writing actually any character, you would require 3 to 5 stroke and lifting on the hand. And at that time of the era, like where we have the royalty and we have kings and queens, then, to write down the royal edicts, we needed something cursive, shorthand, or speed writing. So the Modi was invented. And in Modi, the cursive also known as Lapet Dar. And at that time of the era, Modi became extremely popular and was used heavily. So the evolution of the Modi actually gone through 4 transition period, and I will be giving the snapshot of script in my upcoming slides. So first era is Bahamani Kalin era, which is the period of 1400 to 1600. Basically, in this era, this script, Modi script, was heavily influenced by Perso-Arabic. Perso-Arabic, Urdu, Sindhi, Kashmiri, they comes from the Perso-Arabic script. So in this image, if you see that this is not very cursive, even the consonant cluster or letters are disconnected to each other. Though it is little cursive, you can see that some of the letters are joining, some of the characters are joining, but this is not cursive, fully cursive in nature. And this image is the snapshot of the letter of Shivaji Maharaj. Shivaji Maharaj basically was a ruler of, was a great ruler and founder of the Maratha Empire in Western India. So these letters have been found while doing the research on Modi. And then the next era is Shiv Kalin, which is from 1600 to 1700. And this era is also, the script is partially very influenced by, again, Perso-Arabic. But if you see the evolution, that script is little cursive in nature. And now consonant clusters and consonants are joining to each other. They are not disconnected. So this is little cursive, and you can, without lifting your hand, you can do the speed writing. Then comes the Sahu Kalin era, which is also known as Peshwa Kalin era, which is from 1700 to 1818. And here, the curves are more marked and elongated. So if you see that some of the characters here, they are more elongated in nature and more cursive in nature. Then the final era, which is Angla Kalin era, which is from 1818 to 1947. In this era, actually, first half of the British period, English and Modi both coexisted together. So even in the research, we found out that some of the newspaper were also written in both Modi and English. And however, with the innovation of moving metal type in that era, the spread of English language has been increased, and the downfall of Modi script was started. Now comes to Modi writing system details. So although Modi is inherited from the Devanagari, but it differs considerably from the Devanagari in terms of letter forming, rendering behavior, and orthography, because Devanagari is not so cursive in nature. So we needed some other kind of letters and their rendering behavior. As I already told that Modi was cursive, shorthand, and used for speed writing. And some of the notable features which Modi has, like it has, it doesn't have short and long vowel forms. Then it uses some certain specific markers for numerical notation, and then conjuncts, which are like consonant virama consonant or consonant clusters. They are marked either by use of virama or half characters. This is the snapshot of the Modi letter forms. So vowel, consonant, then numerals, consonant, matra combination, how they attached. So this has been taken from our font, which we have designed and developed, called as Modi Sahu font. So basically, this is just to show you the glimpse how Modi look and how it display. Then we have also given the comparison between Modi and other heritage script like Mahajani, Landa, and Kathi. They all are heritage script, and the government of India actually are now pushing very hard to preserve these scripts, as and when you know, these are now being lost, and we have very less documents available, very less images available. So if we actually compare Modi with other heritage script or Devanagari, the letters, the similarity is very much there. So because they are either variant or influences from the Devanagari. So if you see that letter Cha, this letter is very much similar in all of the script except Landa. Landa is more actually cursive. And then if you see this character Nya, this is very much similar to these two script, but here this is very much different. So they have the similarity and they have their own differences. Now comes to the overview of tools. These tools have been developed by C-DAC, and they have been given as a part of the single application for digital archivation and preservation. So first one is Modi Sahu font, and this font is specially designed font as per the letter forms, rendering behavior, and orthography. This font fulfill all the basic requirements such as structure and form of the character for better digitization. So this font is based on Unicode, and the Unicode code block which belongs to Modi is 11600. So Unicode recently encoded Modi in their Unicode code block. So this is font is designed on that, based on Unicode. Then we have Modi typing tool. This is developed for inputting the text in Modi script. And this keyboard, basically what you see is based on the inscript principle. Inscript, the full form of inscript is Indian script principle. So in India, we have a standard for designing the Indian language keyboards. What this standard says that if you see this keyboard in the left half, you will we will place all the vowels and vowel sign, and in the right part of the keyboard we have all the consonants and other letters. So the advantage of this keyboard is that, let's say I don't know Modi, but I know other keyboard, Hindi keyboard. So if I know the Hindi keyboard and I know that on the key K, the letter K is placed, then on the same key, Modi K letter will be placed. So even though I don't know the language, but I can type the characters and type the language. This keyboard is also based on Unicode, and whatever you see as a rendering of the characters, the font is getting applied. Then we have also designed the converter, because we have very few experts who know Modi. They basically know the other languages, other script, Devanagari script. So we have designed a converter which converts Modi script to Devanagari script. This is not very visible, but this is the same website in Modi and the other website where using the transliteration tool, we have converted the whole website in Devanagari. Sorry. And finally, we have developed a web application called as Modi Puratan Dastavej Jatan Pranali, which is a digital annotation and archival system. So this is a web application for digital preservation of cultural heritage resources and manuscript. And here what you see that you can actually upload the image and user can annotate the image and type the Modi text using the online typing tool. And virtual keyboard, which I have shown earlier, and transliteration system and the font, Modi Sahu font is part of this application. Conclusion that basically the very important feature is that it is a functional tool for preserving the script for extinction. So the same tool can be used for any other heritage script if needed. And it also facilitates various tools and technologies for the community user to better understand the script and digitize it. And what we feel that since this tool has all the basic basic tools like keyboard font and transliteration tool, but if OCR and search engine, those high-end application, if that could be developed and integrated, then it can increase the usability of the existing system, which is our future proposition. Thank you.